సంసార ఉపరమతే ఉప అనుపరతో భవతి. సంసార విల్నాడే పునరపి జననం పునరపి మరణం పునరపి జననీ జఠరే శయన ఇహ సంసార బహు దుస్తారి. Why we have to read this Bhagavad Gita? Why we have to follow the Karma Yoga? Because if you want to get out of this Janma, then you have to go through Karma Yoga. This is the door towards the Moksha. So Bhagavan Adi Shankaracharya says in Shiva Aparadha Kshamapana Stotra, Ado Karma Prasangat Kalayati Kalusham Matrukukshau Sthitammam Vinmutra Medya Madhye Kotayati Nitaram Jataro Jata Vedaha. This is like Polambal, got that. You getting it? This is tune. You getting it? If it is Ayigiri Nandini Nandite Medini, this is a different tune. Are you getting it? Because she's dancing. Suppose the Ganga Sotra, you see Ganga. Devi Sureshwari Bhagavati Ganga, it's like wave. Are you getting it? Now, suppose you go to some death house as a Polambal. ఆదు కర్మ ప్రసంగాత్ కలయతి కలుషం మాతృకుక్ష స్థితం మాం. బికాస్ ఆఫ్ పూర్వ కర్మ వి ఫెయిల్ ఇన్ మాతృకుక్ష, దెన్ వి కమ్ అవుట్ టు క్రియేట్ ప్రాబ్లం. కమ్ అవుట్, గో టు స్కూల్, దిస్ ఇస్ యువర్ టీచర్.
ఐ డోంట్ లైక్ దిస్ టీచర్. యువర్ కర్మ, యు హావ్ టు స్టడీ ఫ్రమ్ హెర్.
I don't like this school. You have to go to school, study mathematics, science, and how many years? 12 years. No, pre-KG, LKG, UKG, two more years, 14 years. LKG, UKG, then totally 14 years. Now you understand why Rama went to forest 14 years. You getting it? We understand now. The symbolic meaning of 14 years. Why Kaiki asked Rama? Very nice. Very nicely, the Kamban says, Yedirinda Aandin Thirumbiva Endra Yambina Narasan Endral. This is about 14 years. Then go to college. I don't want. Go! 10th plus 2 finished college. There also you have to study. Yes, you have to study. Come back, get some job. Okay, they are not giving. You have to find out. Get married. Me too? Yeah. We all married and suffering. You also. Now I want to go to as brahmachari. No! Impossible. We will not allow you to be happy in your life. Come back. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Let them go, you come. Marry. Before marriage, thrilling, 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 thrilling. After marriage, thrilling. Very nice. Very nice. Interesting. So two lines. So the two lines are marrying. Two lines. The man line. The woman line. I do not know what is the English term. Man and woman, okay? Two lines. Marrying. One small rat came. So they invited all animals in the forest. Small rat came. I was dancing. Small rat is dancing. I was like, hey, why are you dancing? My brother line is getting married. Hey, you belong to rat category. This is lion. Before marriage, I was lion. Before marriage, I was lion. No, in this context, I remembered. Purposefully, I didn't say anything, okay? Simply came to my thought, I shared with you, that's all. There is no intention behind this joke. Okay? The marriage is suffering, then the children. Then you have, again, the same process starts. You have to go to school. Why? I went to school, you go. Go to that office. I also. You also get married. Again the same person. Ne? One day I will die. Again the same person next Janma. Are you getting it? Somewhere you have to get bored. Hey, this is enough. That's why he says, Yella Pirapum Piranda Lite. How many liters of sambar we drank? How many idlis? Sambar inside the idli, idli inside the sambar. That's what I say. How? Never getting bored. Hey, Ascharya. We have to get out of this kind of circle. That's why, hey, come on. Abrahma Bhuvana Loka Punaravarthino Arjuna Mamupetita Kaunteya Punarjanmana Vidyate. Just to cut off this cycle of birth and death. For that, what should I do? You have to do karma yoga. Do your activity, I will tell you the technique, how to do it. That's why we have to read this Bhagavad Gita, understand what is to be followed, how it is to be followed, what's advisedly we have to break the shell and you have to go out of this samsara. It's given very nice book. Out of compassion he brought Bhagavan, Krishna. So Gurudev brought this commentary. We are very, very lucky people. Very lucky. We have the medicine here for our, disease. But keeping the medicine will cry. Medicine is there. Where? Bhagavad Gita. I studied many times, nothing has happened. More than 20 years, Gurudev says, you have gone through Gita. Gita should go through you. Very nice. Very nice. So when we take this knowledge, so we are the powerful and very happy person this world is. The ordinary people, Gurudev says, the ordinary person. Before the problem, we are wise. After the problem, we are wise. During the problem, we are otherwise. He says that. Gurudev says, very nice. When we learn this Bhagavad Gita, before wise, after wise, during the problem also, we will be wise. This is the result of Bhagavad Gita. Okay, when are you going to start 11th sloka? Now. How will you start 11th sloka?
Natve vaham jatuna.
First finish, eh? Oh, sorry. I have to explain this. I lost myself. You excused me, eh? Thank you. The first sloka, asochanan vasochastum prajnavadamscha bhashase. Gadasuna gadasumscha nanusochanti panditaha. Very nice. Asochyan, not to be grieved. Anvasochastum. You have grieved for the person, the people, those not to be grieved. Anvasochastum. So unnecessarily you are worrying about the people to whom we should not grieve. Bhishma and Drona. Anyway, they are going to die. You are unnecessarily worrying about Bhishma and Drona. Asochyam, anvasochastam. Anu means the following there. If something happens, after 5 minutes, ayo, you don't know, you know that. After 5 minutes, ayo, you know that. After 5 minutes, ayo, you know that. Anvasochastam. Continuously worrying about this thing. One complete chapter you spoke. Asochan anvasochastum prajnavadamscha bhashase. You are, bringing the words of wisdom. Prajnavadamscha bhashase. Gada asu. Asu means here prana. Gada asun means the dead body, dead people. Agadasumscha, the living person. Gadasu or agadasu. Gadasun, agadasumscha. Panditaha nana sochanti. This pandita. Pandita means here not the pandit who is doing puja in the temple. Here Bhagavan Adishankaracharya says that pandita means atma vishaya buddhi. When we create the buddhi of atma vishaya, that atma vishaya buddhi is called panda. Eshamte panditaha. Those who are having this atma vishaya buddhi, they are called pandita. Not simply those who are doing the puja in the temple. This is a different pandita. There's different pandits. Here, panditaha nanu sochanti. Well versed in atma tattva, pandita. When we are well versed in atma tattva, so we will not worry about the dead person or living person. Both are same. Gadasun, agadasum, chananu so very powerful, this sloka. Unnecessarily you are worrying about Bhishma and Drona, not to be grieved. So you are grieving. Asochan, anu sochastam, prajnavadam, chabhasha. You are talking all about that. The wise. Likewise, you are talking. Prajnavadamscha bhashase. Gadasuna agadasumscha nanu sochandi pandita. Actually, this is the Atma Jnana. He is giving very directly to Arjuna. All the slokas, now 20 slokas contain only Atma Tattva. Very higher level slokas. How can we present the, what's that, death house without crying? He says that. Gada soon. The person died here. The person is living. When you see this, both the Pandita people will not, what's that, get disturbed. Whether it is Asugata or Na Asugata. For Pandita, both are same only. The peak of the knowledge. Sometimes we consider this, even though this person is living, I consider this person is dead person. Why, he is useless. To whom he is useless? For me only. Useless, dead person. These 20 slokas only remove the worry of Arjuna immediately. Without this knowledge, you will not get up from a sort of hysteria, what do you call, neurotic condition. When Vali was hit by Rama, in Valmiki Rama, when Vali was hit, Rama came, and all of the monkeys, the main monkeys, the monkey leaders came. At the time, Tara also came. Tara fell down on Vali and started crying. So Rama was so compassionate. He asked Hanuman to console Tara. Hanuman says almost the same shloka like this. Sochya. This is the word. Sochya sochasi kam sochyam. Dinam dinanu kampase. Kascha kasyanu sochosti. Dehesmin budbudopame. One day this body will die. Like what, the bubble in the water. Hey Tara, why you are worrying about this, the body? Hanuman. Sochya sochasi kam sochyam. Actually, Tara, you have to think about your own death. You are thinking about he is going to die and you are crying. Actually, you have to think about your own death and you should know how to get out of your own death. You are already socha. You are, what is that, sochasi towards Vali. Very powerful slope. Only this Atma Jnana only can bring us from the, what is that, the worries of this kind of, what is that, this kind of worries. The same shloka, almost the same sound and same shloka he brought, Hanuman. In Pondicherry, in cremation ground, I didn't go inside, but from the outside, I saw. Everybody one day we will die. No? Why unnecessarily you are worrying about this Bhishma Drona? One day we will die. That one day we do not know. Mrityu Sannihite Kale, Bajagovinda. We do not know when he will take us. One day we will die. In that cremation ground, the entrance, they have written the wall. In river, the dead body they are taking inside. In river, nalaini. That means today this person is going inside the cremation ground. Tomorrow you. Powerful, huh? In Pandicherry, somewhere the cremation ground, the wall they have written. One day we'll. Why unnecessarily worrying about the living person, the dead person? The living person also the Atma presence is there. The dead body also Atma's presence is there. Pandita, he understood about the Atma Tattva. Atma never goes from one body to another body. Only Jiva goes. Atma is everywhere. When Atma is everywhere, it is there, this presence is there in the living body and the dead body. Pandita, one who understands this, he will not grieve. This is the point. Hey Arjuna, you look at me. I am not, what is that, grieving for anything. I know, I understood. With the complete balance, the man of wisdom, I am telling you that wisdom, just to take this and don't worry, fight against this people. Very powerful. One day we'll die. One day this Bhishma Drona will die. Arjuna says, one day they are going to die. Why should I kill them? Let them die themselves. Because of the Kshatriya Dharma, this has arrived at your, what's that, hand. You have to kill them. But you understand, the Atma Satyam, the Jagat Mithya. This is the point he is going to explain in the 20 slokas. Next sloka. We are going to see the whole 20 slokas, okay? All Vedantic slokas, very highest truth is indicated through 20 slokas. One was that goal, and the indicators are many here. You should not get bored, okay? So it will go beyond our head sometimes. Not sometimes, the 20 slokas. 20 slokas will go beyond. The highest goal he shows first. Very highest. Very powerful, very interesting also. This is called the real Vedanta. The real Vedantic slokas, Upanishad, what's that? The content he brings here, 20 slokas. Sometimes you do not understand where I am sitting. When you read this sloka, now you see. The next sloka will get the giddiness. But very interesting. Actually, when you read Bhakti Grandha, it's enjoyable. Bhakti Grandha is joyful. This Vedantic Grantha, the Vedantic truth is ascharya. When you understand, when you understand this Atma Tattva and the body is perishing, Atma is not the imperishable, when we understand, we say, ascharya feeling. Suppose after 20 slokas also, Krishna says that ascharyavat paschati kaschidenam, ascharyavat vatati tataiva chanyaha. Ascharyava chainam anyashrunotu shrutva apyenam vedana chaiva kaschit is going to tell. The person speaks very ascharya, the subject of ascharya, the atma, okay? Ascharya. And the man hears with all ascharya, wonder. The person speaks the wonderful subject. The man hears the wonderful subject. The wonderful thing is, having heard this 20 slokas, the man says, I don't understand anything. This is a very, very wonderful person. Because the topic is very subtle. Very subtle. We'll go to the next sloka.